know, she's just helping out the crack as long as she, I have no new.
Your tongue is stubborn.
I brought my girl home when she was 5 months. She'll be 16.
Wow.
He's lying.
Hello, darling.
We just came back from the walk here. It's four hours, so she's. Why didn't?
Stop it, Bonnie.
Are these on the fifth old run? Yes, they're 3 years old.
What are they, siblings?
Brother and sister. Rocket is the darker one and she's the female. They dumped them in their backyard for 3 years after their dog had puppies and then they decided to have a longer time for them and took them to PACC. They knew that makes no manners, like nothing. When they first started coming up 2 weeks ago, she spent all her time under the couch. She was in that ball.
Oh my gosh.
So, yeah, they've come so far.
She's like, I'm relaxed.
Especially being small breed dogs, they would have been easy to give away. I mean, there's no reason they had to keep that shape.
Probably loved that.
You know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I know, I agree.
They should be prosecuted.
Really?
We all know they're sentient.
I mean, for three-year-old dogs, really.
It's amazing that they're not just about. Yeah.
They're out walking.
That's, I think that's one of the reasons I love getting seniors in their homes too, because they truly appreciate it. Like, they know, like, how bad it was before, so. Thank you. Like, the puppies, like, they don't know any better. They just roll with it, you know, but the older dogs.
Until they know different.
Right.
I work as a senior. Adults and their dogs because they know it. Those dogs are so well-being and so loved.
Yeah.
Because they know.
Yes, they know. They've got a really good home by morning.
Yeah, right?
Well, and I think that's used to now when they get out here, because we transport the dogs back and forth each day to PACC. So when they get here each day, they know what they're coming to now and they're excited. You do. Good job. Thank you. So, and that's what we do, is we bring them up from the shelter in the mornings, they spend the day with us and they go back and down. They have a good dog for the foster. So, and the transformation of these two has been, it's just incredible to watch. He came out of his shell more quickly, the lighter one, but she has, this is the first day that she spent almost her entire day out on the couch. So, it's really been a fun thing to watch that happen.
I'll just show you my dog.
Oh, she just got the new one. She's been holding off by getting another one, but she couldn't anymore.
Me?
Yeah, now she's got it. And that puppy is still a puppy.
And he knows how loved he is.
He might play it in his little tooth, it's sharp. He's having a good time chewing it.
Well, yeah, they just like kids.
Remember, yeah?
That's right. That's first.
Buttons. Everything that he's done, he's just been perfect. He's listened to him. And somebody loved him before.
Those are the ones that are amazing. And we get them sometimes with kids. It's really perfect. Well behaved, not destructive, bodies outside, no commands.
I got one of those dogs.
I wouldn't like to say that. The last time I walked in, he said, it takes a while.
I was like, yeah, he's used to it. You have to give up.
He's body trained. He likes to ride grass.
Yeah. It's like, oh no.
That's it. Life's short.
You've only had him for a few weeks, so he'll get there.
That's right.
So now you should get two.
Well, if I go, but they're getting decorated
in my shoe.
This was
fine.
That was fun. Yeah.
Well, you know, we'll afternoon flight.
Is choosing to scare that dog. But he knows. I mean, he knows. Then he looks at me and he goes,
okay, everybody, I hope you're going to be a dog. Of course. My babies. Oh.
He's not ready for stuff yet.
You know, she was a puppy. Look how cute she can show him. What do you mean?
She's told, she's.
And you think he's gonna say something?
She keeps saying that eight, and that must be behind you a while. Because like, when she got your.
Take it off and chew like you chew the other half.
But I've never had anybody call me the same thing over and over and over.
He chewed.
Eight years old.
They find him surrender?
Yeah, they brought him into PACC, and the reason for surrender was, you don't have time for that. You couldn't even save the time for him. That's a whole other three years.
You need to say, I'm just all the way on it like this, just stay in my own.
I said, she already forgot he chewed up the straw hat. Into a shred.
It might last 45 seconds.
Yes.
It would take a long enough.
It would just like pieces.
It'd be a dog toy.
It would.
That is.
Well, that's more for you than him.
Yesterday or Friday, he came in going down. I'm just on Friday, I'm gonna talk to Boston this weekend. And bought that.
I thank you.
On the boots, bought a little, it's a little Pomeranian, a little pink collar with a banana. And what was the other thing? Oh, and sunglasses.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, sunglasses.
The ones back there are out for a walk right now, so.
About like bumping, you know, taking walls out and stuff, and Mark said, don't put any money in there because you're probably
gonna
walk. So we go to the back, you know, it's the bathroom slash kitchen for the dogs, and then they're like, so what's this? I said, well, that's actually the storage room, and I said, and it's just full. And they both look in, and Laura looks at me, she says, really, Bonnie? I said, we've done this twice now. I said, shut up, it's been organized.
Yeah.
I said, she says, so what's in here? I said, oh, this is my office. Hold on.
Yes, you are.
Open the door and put the light. She goes, what is this?
This is me.
I think we're bulging the seams.
I said, I have no room for anything. I said, this is why I can't do any more here, because I have no room for anything.
Right.
Can you imagine if I had to worry about inventory? Where the hell would I put it?
Right.
It's full. That office is now full of crates, dog beds. Cans of food.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, all
stacks.
That stuff.
So we probably won't even have anything else, huh?
Yeah,
apparently.
What's that?
We probably need to clean all that. Yeah. At least we know that when we come here to do that, Jimmy's
office. Do
you remember how depressing it was when we pulled everything out of that room the first time?
We had to put it on the
end. Because it was huge. All the way down to here. Like, we just lined the. We stepped out at one point and we just looked at each other like, what have we done?
We had no choice. We had to put it back.
Yeah, it all had to go back. Holy cow.
That's
easy.
Good job.
Girl. Come say hi.
There we go. Perfect.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, that's why I was telling them. I said the foot traffic here is not about adoptions and fosters. I said it's of the people that come here to adopt a foster have seen these dogs either at PACC or on our pages.
You have a rare ones that come in and, oh, this is...
Yeah, but...
But usually they have a child, you know.
Not very many, yeah. So, but I think that could be, and they could turn this into a destination for a lot of people to come up here in the first place to come to the mall.
Well, yeah, the mall has a lot to gain by working that out, because...
Yeah.
I mean, look at the old cup mill pet shops.
Right. They were a big block of people.
Oh, yeah. And still, you can still go. So...
Yeah, he was saying, he was quite a two-time... He'd be able to collect some good dogs. Or a donation.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the mall, but...
And I think they'd be on board.
Yeah, I mean, if she could do pretty well.
She may have to renegotiate with them. I don't know if they could have done it.
These two are out.
She might have to fumble for price.
Everybody else is out or gone. Have you looked at any of the stations?
Nothing specific. I had a conversation with the director and a board member from Friends of PACC on Friday. So we're probably going to end up partnering.
Does that mean?
There's a lot of question marks there right now, and I don't know, but likely having two locations and this becoming more of like Cleveland's malls. But there's a lot, just a preliminary discussion at this point. Like, for something to cause that level of pain, like, my knee was swollen and everything. And I was like, how am I not more out of this? Like, if I had gone to a doctor, if I found a doctor,
I'm going to look at your
bandana. I literally don't know. And unless I know I've got a pain in my left hip. I'll fall apart.
Warranty expired.
Exactly. What you're saying is, keep something like a treat. Because I'm so used to seeing her here in Brady.
I know.
And I was like, who is that? And I realized, oh,
someone
in the first day. She's allowed to get you a treat. Go for the country, did he? He said he would be back by the
So you have to get his flight plan ready.
I couldn't believe what he told him. He's a magician.
Really?
Yeah.
Not me.
Yeah, he's the guy that comes in, shorter guy, short gray hair, comes in and gives the treats to the dogs. Yeah, so we found out his name is Bill. But all this time, and he was a pilot. He was like, oh no. I do sleight of hand, is how he described it.
You got his pilot, and he's a magician.
That's hilarious. Right? He's okay because. No, it's right up here. Because he walks, it's all within walking distance. He told me once, and I don't remember, but I know it's a
slight
problem.
Yeah.
Not at all.
Yeah. Yeah. That's so cute. Oh, I want another puppy. I already have Ted.
Ted?
Yeah.
It's a puppy litter.
So, if anyone needs Rottweiler, Doberman mixes, we have.
Oh,
wow.
Oh, cute. Nuna, stop.
Oh, I'm
Nuna.
Sorry.
Good job, Nuna.
You are the cutest.
Yeah, I'm working on my dog with that.
Well, she's been a real handful for a while.
Really?
In the last week, I know she's been much
a little better.
Something just clicked.
I mean, I probably helps to have people walk in. My dog definitely didn't get enough like of the socialization because I got her right when like COVID was going on.
Yeah.
So like a whole puppy time that I should should have had her out when we were on lockdown, so now she's very timid in public.
Yeah.
But she's getting better at it.
Yeah. Yeah, little by little.
Oh, really?